UNICEF estimates that one in every 20 girls aged 15 to 19 have experienced forced sex during their lifetime. Other reports show that one in every three girls living in Nigeria experiences at least one form of sexual assault by the time they reach 25 years old. Advocacy, sensitization, and effective communication in the community is crucial in tackling rape, child molestation, and domestic violence at the grassroots level. This is why the International Visitor Leadership Program of the United States Consulate General Lagos, Nigerian Association of Women Journalists B-Zone, and other stakeholders are partnering with communities in Lagos State to sensitize male and female residents to sexual-based violence. Recently, the group partnered with Oriade Local Council Development Area to educate women, men, and youth in the area, as well as emphasizing the importance of parental care.
Even when our children make mistakes, let them be free to come to us, to confess to us. That's why we are parents, so that we can correct them, even if we can punish them, or correct them and lead them around. That is the essence. And finally, that's the essence that they were still alive. And finally, anyway. So that I want more while we don't know more.
It's a very good program. I think we have such thing about some years back. And today's zone, I think it's a very good thing. So that we parents should know our weaknesses. When your home is okay, your children, they will be happy. And parents, it is the mother that has a lot of work to do on children.
The way our society is going, the ethics are being eroded away as a result of unusual happenings. And it is a good thing coming up this time around to enlighten our men and our boys that come. There are some things that are antisocial and we dare not dabble into them. And we should also consider the trauma the recipient of rape receive after the sin. So it's not something to encourage in a society that has the aspiration for development.
They urged victims of sexual and domestic violence to always speak out.
It's very simple. Speak out, Sorosoke. Don't hide. Don't feel like the devil for speaking out. Don't let anybody intimidate you, because the effect cuts across, you know, psychological health and all that. So, but when you speak out, you get the help, the healing, the closure that you deserve. So it's very simple. Speak out so that you can get help and be properly healed. It's important because we don't want to have to keep having damaged people in our communities.
What we have decided is that we will go to the grassroots to advocate concerning the issue of domestic violence, rape and child molestation. Why we brought this case to the local government administrator, they have the ears of their people. They know them at the grassroots, they know the community, they know the interior, where we can get to. And that's why we felt that, okay, with their support with us, we'll be able to reach out to more people and create awareness about the issue of child molestation. Many people don't believe in the community that it exists. Some knows that it is existing, but they don't want to talk. Some want to talk, but there's this naming thing, shaming thing, that stigma, that if you talk it or if you tell people, you'll be stigmatized. Community will look at you as, why will you go out and say it? Some make effort. They make effort to reach out to governments, but they are bullied, they are threatened, so they withdraw. So that is one of the reasons why we felt that the local government is in a better place to reach out to the people at the grassroots in terms of advocacy and talking about child molestation, rape, and domestic violence.
The purpose of telling us to come and listen and hear what they had is for us to disseminate this program and the information to the community members, the women and the men. And in fact, when we have our meeting, we have to talk about it so that we know exactly what to do, the phone number they gave us, and when anybody has something that has to do with something like this, including us too. When we hear about it, even if we don't go to the, we call them, they don't answer, we have the CD, we have the police station around us to call and let them know exactly what is going on.
What we are taught today will go a long way to assist our children and to stop domestic violence. We will need to disseminate the information to our members in various CDA so that those that are involved in domestic violence will desist.